Hey, Sonny, what are you working on?
Oh, I'm working on a PrintStation demo.
Oh, PrintStation? Doesn't that allow you to use a Zebra printer in a standalone function?
Yeah, I just finished the demo. You want to check it out?
Yeah, let's check it out.
The link to the knowledge article to set up the demo is just below at the bottom of your screen. The demo I created is a mock retail returns demo, but with the information in the knowledge article, you can edit the demo to suit your needs. We'll go through the demo real quick. We're just going to scan the item to be returned. We're going to scan the return category. We're going to scan the damage category. We're going to scan the associate ID. And we're going to scan the print quantity. That's it.
One last item I'd like to quickly cover is the code that makes up this particular PrintStation demo. I divided up the code into five sections to illustrate the key concepts. The first section, highlighted in blue, is what writes this code to the printer's internal memory. In this case, we are telling the printer to write the code to the printer's eDrive and call the program returnsDemo. This is what we see when we enter into PrintStation mode from earlier in the video. The second section, highlighted in purple, is recalling the Zebra logo that is stored on the printer's eDrive. If you recall, earlier, we stored this logo onto the printer's eDrive when we did the USB mirror step. Now, this snippet of code is simply recalling that image from that stored file. The third section, highlighted in red, is simply just fixed text describing this label. This text can be anything and can be edited to your needs. The fourth section, highlighted in orange, is pulling the current date and time from the printer's real-time clock. This allows us to have an accurate timestamp and proof of when the return was created. The fifth and final section, highlighted in green, is telling the printer that this data is custom data that is coming in from the attached USB HID device. This could be a barcode scanner or a keyboard, for example. This code tells the printer to wait for the data to be entered from the external device and which order it should be asking for the data. For example, FN1 is the first data that is asked for. FN2 is the second data that is asked for, and so on. And that is a quick overview of the PrintStation returns demo. Hopefully this helps illustrate some of the key concepts and capabilities utilizing PrintStation for standalone printing. Feel free to play around and make edits to the code as needed. Stay tuned for more short, helpful tutorials, and thank you for choosing Zebra.